Good evening and welcome to another conversation with John Conenna. Tonight, we are proud and honored to have on Chicago vocalist Daniela Crocco, also a member of the Jersey Girls.
And that's right.
It's really nice, Daniela, because this is something different for me because I normally interview Chicago sports athletes. And of course, we call up on a lot of Chicago journalists. So this is going to be our first, I'm going to put it in this realm, singing star. So
awesome.
Thanks for coming
on. I'm
honored.
Yeah.
So what's going on, young girl?
A lot. I mean, okay. I don't really know where to start.
Yeah.
Where do I start?
Well, let's start it this way. How do you get this passion to do what you're doing? And of course, this is what I call a good grind, meaning, you know, you got to be prepared every night. You know, sometimes when people go out, they see you and they're like, oh, yeah, I can do this. This is a, you know, it's a job, but it's a job that I see in all the things that you've done, because there's a lot of people that I'm going to bring up later on in this. I could see you're very passionate about it. Shows, and our body language shows that, but when do you start with this? Meaning, where? How old do you think you were when you wanted to say, "Hey, you know what? I think I could, you know, kind of dabble around, do a little singing, a little dancing." When does that start for you?
You know, it's funny when I had that moment, that exact moment you just said, like, "Oh, you know, I think I could actually do this as a living." It was like in high school, maybe even slightly younger, but I would say high school.
Yeah.
Because obviously growing up, I was in church choir. I was always in something where, whether it was choir, then being in school, doing musical theater, dance, cheerleading, something in that involved like entertaining people, being on a stage, performing in any aspect, right?
Right.
In middle school, I started getting into the musical theater, right? And just, it really was just the audience. It was people and even teachers and mentors coming up to me. You have a gift. There's something there. You need to pursue this. Like, people, I would hear this over and over again from even strangers in the audience. Like, that was really good. And they couldn't believe my age. And I'm like, okay, I guess I'm good at this. So I start taking voice lessons. And then honestly, once I started getting into voice lessons, then I start performing more. I know, I'm like, okay, yeah, I'm definitely, not to sound cocky, but
no.
I'm like, all right, I'm good at what I do. And I really think if I keep up at it, I can, you know, kind of do this as a living.
Right. And again, how old were you when this was that? I know you might have mentioned it, but I missed it. How old were you?
When I had this realization, like high school.
Okay, high school. And you know what? Here's the thing that's really neat about this, about you, for me.
Yeah.
Me and your mom are cut from the same cloth, meaning we come from this town called Mbari.
Right.
So, you know, we grew up that same way where our parents were the types who were going to say, you know what? No, this is a too much. You crazy. You know, all that kind of stuff goes on in an Italian household. But with your mom and people like your mom and your dad, I felt like there was a modernization to them. When you said,
I guess that I never really thought about that, but it's true. Like, no one, don't get me wrong. I won't name any family members, but I definitely have some family members that, you know, pretty much my whole life, oh, you know, you're still doing that. Oh, okay. You know, even now, I know people are skeptical because it's not your normal thing. It's not like your normal thing. Like, oh yeah, I sing. Like, even, I'll be honest, when I see strangers or just whatever, I don't really tell people right off the bat, like, I'm a singer. Right. I don't know. I just don't. They'll learn it and they'll figure it out. But people already, they just hear that and they kind of put you in a category and be like, oh yeah, this girl's a singer. Okay. You know?
Yeah. But you know what, Danielle, I think in a lot of respects, like you're talking about, like, and we have that in that same family, there's that sense of like, almost like that sense, I hate to use this word, that sense of jealousy. Like, oh, like,
yeah,
what does she think she's doing? You know, is she the next, you know, Gloria Estefan in her head? But, you know, you've taken it to a different level where you have risen the bar every year since the time that I've seen you to now. And, you know, you're getting called upon in different situations. So
believe me, I am experiencing a lot of that because, you know, especially with this industry, opportunities are endless. I could be singing in just a casual restaurant like Bellagio, right?
Right.
I'm using Bellagio as an example because we perform all the time. Love Bellagio. Like, they're amazing. But then a billionaire in Florida is calling us to go do a private party in his mansion. Like, talk about total different extremes of, like, opportunities and getting flown out to California to be invited to do a show. Like, all these opportunities, it's like, oh, okay. So I'm here in California this weekend, and then I'm just in some casual Italian restaurant the next weekend.
But it comes from that little Italian casual restaurant. There could be in the guy in the restaurant.
Exactly. You never know.
You know, I interviewed Rob Johnson of Channel 7 News, and he saw you, I think it was up at Arcata on a Sunday with his wife.
Oh, wow.
And it says, wow. You know, he goes, do you know that family? I says, yes, I do. And, you know, again, somebody like a Johnson, that was just like me with this. I interviewed a guy who wrote a book about the Cubs. And the next thing I know, Mark G. and Greco's calling me, who used to do the sports on Channel 7. So you just don't know. Right. No, that was a good point by you. So do you remember, like, right out of high school, does it start you being just a vocalist, or does it become where you kind of, how does this Jersey girl thing start? Which comes first? Are you doing the vocal?
Right out of high school, I went to performing arts college.
Okay.
But even, like, I would say my senior year of high school and a little bit while, like, I was in college still, I was casually singing. I was, like, partnered with this Italian guy. I'm with my DJ. I still, you know, well, we perform together. Alex DJ is what he's called. He's,
yeah,
like,
DJ Alex. He's out of DJ Chiller
Alex.
Park.
Sure, yeah. He's Alex, like, my, he's like, I'm like his granddaughter. He's like my,
yeah, great,
you know,
guy. Great guy.
I mean, he's the best. I really started with him. And of course, you know, he does all the dinner dances, like pescatore, you know, like all these different. I would Altavilla, do that.
Berettas,
of course. That's what I was doing. And not like I was doing a full on show. Like, believe me, I was this clueless. I have no idea what I'm doing. I'm just used to this musical theater world. And I don't, you know, I'm like learning how this really works, especially in Chicago. Like, you don't think, like, I had a realization, like, wow, I can actually say I am a well-known performer in Chicago, Illinois. Like, that's we're a big state. We're a big city.
Big city.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah.
To say and think about. So yeah, I was in musical theater, and that, so I was in school, and it was while I was in school, I remember seeing the Jersey Girls before even Sonia, the other girl with the long hair, before she was involved. I remember seeing the girls, and it was their original trios. Deanna's the only one that's been the OG, I guess I would say, since day one. I remember seeing them at the Arcata Speakeasy. I was 19.
In St. Charles.
I think I was like 19, maybe 20. I was 19. I don't even remember. I was very young. And I remember, again, not to be cocky, I'm really not, but I remember sitting in, I was like in the back of the speakeasy, and I'm watching these three girls performing, and I'm like, I literally could do this. Because at the time, I'm like trying to get myself out there, understand the performance world in Chicago. And so I'm like, I'm looking at all these different entertainers.
Sure.
And I just remember watching them, and I'm like, I literally could do this. Like, this is what I do. I'm in theater. Like, I do this. If I'm like, I do the showmanship type of performing. And then what do you know? Here I am now.
Oh,
and then
God.
Jersey Girls is better than ever. It's the best it's ever been. So,
I mean, but it was from, so from that moment, you were able to kind of get into this group with these ladies.
And not from that particular moment, but it happened over time. Like, really, so how the door opened, at one point, they had posted on Facebook that they were hiring another member. Like, they're looking for another member. So, of course, oh, wow. I messaged them. Never got a message back from them. But Ron Onesti, I know, is really pushing me in their direction. And it was Sonia's birthday party. Like, they had a show on for Sonia's birthday. So they invited like special guest entertainers. I was one of them. So I purposely made an effort. At this time, I think I was freshly 21.
Wow.
Freshly 21.
And Onesti had heard you sing, of course.
They've never heard me sing.
Oh, they had never heard
me sing. I purposely went out there. Because I'm like, let me just, you know, show off a little bit, just because I know once they hear me and see what I can do, I just knew it was going to lead to maybe something. And that's exactly what happened. Because from there, that's when Deanna and I don't know who else was there at the time, but Deanna, like, we were set aside. The time it was just, we're looking for a fill-in. Okay, because Irina, they didn't really announce that Irina was actually leaving yet. So the time it was just, oh, you can be a film. I was like, yeah, absolutely. Sure. Then it turned into, okay, we're looking for a new member. But they told me they were auditioning other girls. And I'm like, okay, sure. But I knew. It's funny. I even told Deanna this exact story. I was like, I remember when you guys did this. And I literally in the back of my head, I'm like, yeah, okay, you're auditioning other people.
Right.
I'm like, let me know how that goes for you. Because I knew. I was so confident. I was very confident. Okay. Like, I knew I had it. You know, I was very confident, but I sound like I'm so like cocky and
no, you're right sure now, yourself. But that's the word we should use here. You're sure yourself, but
yeah.
What comes with the role? To correct me if I'm wrong, because I wasn't a part of this. But what comes with their role? You should be cocky about it. Is this? It comes your voice, your choreography. You had to, you know, be able to move and everything else. The look. And everything else, and the modernization of the girl to fit this form of the Jersey Girl. So yeah, this all comes into play. If not, was, and I don't want to cut down that, you know, it was just about the voice. You had to have what I call in anything, the whole package, correct?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, for sure. I want to go back to a question I wanted to ask, you know, we got a little bit of a head, but I didn't mind.
Okay.
You know, somebody could be singing in a shower and say, oh yeah, I can do that song by, Luther Vandross. I can do it in the shower, you know. When did you have a vocalist that helped you over the years, like a professional that, you know, took you through it? Was there voice lessons? What goes on?
Oh, like a voice. Oh, yeah. I've been in voice lessons since.
Yeah, take us through
since
that. I mean,
eighth grade, like consistently since eighth grade. Now, I would say it's not as often just because, you know, I'm an adult now and I have other bills and work gets in the way.
Right.
So I don't. It's hard scheduling lessons consistently now. But I'm back into voice lessons just because, especially for the classical singing that I can do. I've developed some bad habits with singing, meaning, you know, I've lost a bit of my connection and a little bit of my technique that I had when I was stronger, when I was very good at being on top of it. Cause you know, I sing so many different styles of music now. So it's, you know, I would just go singing 3 hours of disco, Donna Summer, Whitney Houston to, oh, please sing Nessun Dorma. And I'm like, oh my God, you don't understand. But then they go and then I'm like, how do I like say no? And I'm like, okay, Right?
Yeah. So, and there's, you used a great word. That's where, if with anything, we fall into the bad habits, you know.
Yeah, I admit it, but every singer they deal with it. It's the muscle. So you have to always strengthen and work on your muscle. But no, my whole life, I would say I pretty much have been in voice lessons with the teacher consistently since eighth grade.
Did you have to find the right one? Like, were your parents involved with this? Were, you know,
not that they were involved in finding me a teacher, obviously, but I'll give my mom a lot of credit. She would drive me to all my lessons.
I could see her. Paid
my lessons at the time. So this is when I was living in Kentucky. I used to be involved there. Was like the local art center. So gotcha. My whole life after school, I'm living at, literally I live at the art center every day. I'm there. My teacher, my dance teacher, their kids, we were best friends at the time.
Oh, wow.
I went to their voice teacher and they lived in Indiana. So I drove all the way to Indiana to see my voice teacher.
Wow.
Keep in mind, in Kentucky, I don't know if you've heard of it, we call it Kentuckiana because some people live literally right over the border. So it's a bridge that separates. Here's Louisville, here's Indiana.
Okay,
so
gotcha.
A lot of people,
yeah.
Yeah, it sounds like, oh my God, Indiana, but really it's just right across the bridge and maybe like 15 minutes outside of the bridge. But still, from where I lived, it's like almost an hour to get there.
Sure.
But I went every week. And this teacher, she passed away a couple of years ago. Oh. I was like devastated.
I can imagine.
Because she is someone that, if I'm telling you, if I did not meet her and start taking her from when I did, I would not be the singer I am right now. She truly shaped.
She was like voice. Could you honestly say, Daniela, that she was like your first mentor?
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Yeah.
I couldn't believe like when I heard found out that she passed away, like, oh my God. It was devastating.
Sure. Yeah. She nurtured you, brought you up through the ranks and everything else. So yeah, that's what I wanted to ask you because, there's a lot of what I call around here club singers, which I think sometimes they don't, they should probably move on to do something
right.
else. But that's why I've heard you sing. And I'll be honest. Doing a little research on you, I'm involved with the 16-inch Chicago, 16-inch Softball Hall of Fame. And I just noticed that, not this past year, but the year before, you sang the national anthem for their opening. So I did a little digging on you, girl.
I didn't know that there's information on that.
Yeah, there's a YouTube of you singing that song. You sang the anthem. And you moved the tiles in the building is what I call it. You moved the tiles in the building. You were with the president having an interview. And of course he was promoting you. And that night you sang the national anthem there. And what I do is two Saturdays a month, I go out to Forest Park and I interview Hall of Famers that have been inducted into the Hall of Fame. And your thing came up and I'm like, oh my God, I'm going to be interviewing. So small world, but
what a small world.
So that's my question for you. I notice like these places like Bellagio, on Arcata, I know you do more of that theme. Is it more of the theme on Arcata or does it change? Well, you're doing more of the Frankie Valli songs.
It's pretty much, I'll be honest, at this point, we are singing whatever we want.
Okay, good.
We do keep it, like we will always have sing the Jersey Boys.
The Jersey
thing, in the beginning of the set. We'll always do that, incorporate, whether it's three songs, four songs, we always have it. And then I'll be honest, the show has pretty much morphed into like disco party music.
My era.
Yeah. I call it too, like just a tribute to all the divas, whether it's male, female, Bee Gees, Donna Summer, Whitney, anybody.
Yeah.
They were all classic, great entertainers,
Gloria Gaynor's in the world. Yes.
Timeless music. You can't not hear it and not want to dance and move. So
how do you feel about singing those songs from that era, which we're talking mid 70s to the late 80s? How does it make you feel? I mean, are those crowds that are coming to the Arcata, Bellagio, this Plains Theater, wherever you're at, are you seeing more? Are you catering more to people my age? You know, because here I am in the early 60s.
Yeah. I would say it's definitely more people your age. We do have some younger fans started to build them up a little bit. But even the younger fans, like, we're still singing our same stuff. Like, and we have some, you know, pop, more current music. But it doesn't matter. Like, everyone still loves it.
Sure.
Oh, yeah. It doesn't matter. That's why it's timeless. Me performing it, I love it. Like, some of my favorite newer melodies that we've, medleys is the word.
Medleys. Okay,
what am I saying? Medleys.
Yeah.
We have like a Bee Gees medley, which is so fun. And we just added a Madonna medley.
Okay.
Super fun. There's
Holiday and Borderline.
They're all like the best songs, and like when you can't help but want to dance and smile, feel good.
And when I, like I said, when I was checking you out, you see some of this, and I even was able to get some old clips from the Arcata from Ren, and you see, you're right, the people are into it, and you know, wow, because now, this era that I was from was like a club era, where you really would go to a club every Friday and Saturday night, and they just never let that go. And you guys, the Jersey Girls, have kept it going. Question. Where do you see this going in the sense of, you are the vocalist. I mean, like if I called you tomorrow and say, hey, tomorrow you are going to be downtown. You're going to sing for Christmas Eve. You know, you're going to sing the national anthem downtown for the tree lighting tomorrow night. You're there, right? I mean, as long as you're there, is there a conflict what you do and what the Jersey Girls do is my question, I guess.
You know, no, I'm going to say no, because since day one, even when I first joined, like I made it very clear, like I still do my own thing, like if I'm getting called, like I was doing, like I sing a lot in the Italian community, and so does Jersey Girls, but it's just because whoever, like, they're calling to hire you as an entertainer, so we all gotta work. There's no contract. They're really like, technically there is no contract. It's not, I tried, like the way I look at it, you know, it's about like being fair. Like obviously if someone hired Jersey Girls and then someone at this party approached you and said, hey, I want to hire you, that's a little different. That's a little bit of conflict of interest. You know, that's the way I look at it. Because, you know, I try to be respectful of like just the group, because the group, I would say I prioritize more, and then everything else is extra. But yeah, I mean, I take whatever, like I get calls all the time for just myself, and if I'm able to, I'll take it. Don't get me wrong, I enjoy singing with the girls, because now they kind of become like security blankets, because when you have to sing for a long period of time, it's exhausting, and then you're by yourself and you have no one else to feed off like energy with, and it's like, okay.
No, right. Exactly.
It's
on the average. Okay. We were talking before we went on here, before we went on live, on the average, what's your schedule like? Let's say, like what was your schedule like this summer? Are you a 4 out of 7 nights a week?
So this summer, so I also had the other job that I was at the spa. And I switched to part-time over the summer. So it was like Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. I mean, we, the whole summer, were pretty much singing Friday, Saturday, all summer, some Sundays, some Thursdays. There was a month, like the month of August was our busiest month. Got it. There was a day where for me, it was a triple gig. for the group, the Jersey Girls, it was a double gig. We had two private parties in one night. And for me, it was triple because I got called to do a wedding ceremony. So I was like, yeah, let's do it. I'm like, I can do that earlier, then leave from there to go to the private party, which is exactly what I did. We finished off there. And then the other people, they wanted us. We're like, listen, we have this party. We can come after. Right. They're like, we'll take it. And we're like, okay, thank God. They were both 5 minutes away from each other. I don't know how that happened, but it did.
But it did.
Yeah, but it was, since this whole year, I would say only a few weekends. October was the slowest month because they took some vacations. But honestly, like looking back, every Friday, Saturday was pretty much booked. We could probably start booking more. We could do that. But especially now, because now I'm transitioning into more full time with singing. Now I'm definitely like looking for those kind of off nights just to do some extra cash or extra side money.
Right,
But the goal is to have every weekend booked pretty much.
Well, yeah, exactly.
And it's becoming that way. It's definitely like each month, like things come. It's kind of crazy. Like,
here you might think it might be dead and all of a sudden something gets filled in, correct? I mean, it looks like, okay, so you're on a tremendous run. The career is going in the right direction. Where do you see yourself? Where would you like to see yourself? I'm going to cut it down a little bit. Where would you like to see yourself in 5 years? Daniela Crocco, Jersey Girls Throw, or the individual vocalist? Or is that question too open-ended?
I guess too open-ended. I don't even know.
But I mean, right now, you could gauge off that, correctly.
Right. Right now, I love singing with the girls. I love whether it's a duo, a trio, doesn't matter. Whoever wants to sing and work, do something together, I'm all about it. We're friends. It's fun. Like me and Deanna, we were talking one day and I was like, honestly, like even if Jersey Girls, no one wants the Jersey Girls, I'm like, what are we going to do? Someone calls us. We're just like, oh, we don't sing together anymore. Sorry. Like what? Like, what does that mean? Like, we're just not going to sing. Like,
right.
Do you know what I mean? Like, so we'll just not be called Jersey Girls. We're the three girls or
the three girls,
whatever, yeah. Right. Whatever we want to be. But I thought about that, like, unless someone moves, who knows? But
Daniela, how long have you guys been the Jersey Girls?
This particular trio, like going on 3.5 years now.
Okay. And you know what? Because maybe all the gigs you have and all these things that you've done, it, to me, that outsider looking in, and of course, this Chicago guy, it seems like it's longer.
I know. Believe me, it feels longer. When I think about it, like, that's it. But it feels like a decade has gone by. I'm serious.
Right,
it's crazy.
Right.
And the year 2020 helped with that because that was just a year that felt like it never ended.
Right.
But no, I mean, for myself, I have different goals in mind, just like whether it's going on tour with Il Volo or like someone like Andrea Bocelli, like that type of
thing. And I know Il Volo for you was big in your onset of your career. I did, again, the little homework on you. You loved Il Volo.
I love Il Volo. I would
Il Mondo.
Seriously, yeah. If I ever sing with them, I will literally pass away. Like I will die. And come back to life. I am obsessed with them. Hope to marry one of them.
Okay. I don't see.
I'll be fine with either one. I prefer the one, but he is a girlfriend.
Daniela, I don't see a problem. You know, you just got to get out there. No, no, but I have to tell you, you know, we haven't dabbled on the Italian community in the sense of this. Have you been approached by like something Italian, meaning from Italy, you know, because I used to do the I used to do the talk show Domenica Insieme every Sunday mornings, and you know, there were a lot of these local Italian people that would, you know, call upon us to come sometimes to the studio. But has anybody asked you, have you sang in Italian with another Italian man from Italy? Nothing like that. Like where you're doing it in English, he's doing it in Italian.
That's
kind of
anyone
like.
that's like of a certain caliber that has a name.
Yeah. Anything like that?
No, not really.
Nothing. Okay.
Not
I was
really.
wondering. Yeah. Something like
Not
that.
really.
So.
But honestly, I'll be honest, like, because just from what I'm feeling right now, I truly believe, like, I'm not even just saying this, I have very good vibes for the year of 2023. I really do.
Okay.
I feel like I've met and I continue to be meeting the right people to help my career. Obviously, there's people that I stay close to, I'm loyal to, like, because I just know, like, these are the people that
sure.
I will always, whether it's not paid, I will always have their back because they have had my back. And that's how I think. You do, you know, you do good to others, like something will happen and come out of that just by you doing a
you
service
know,
like that.
You are correct. I want to ask you this. Are you have some, of course, I'm sure you have a lot of appointments coming up this in the new year, 2023. Are there some things that we're going to see different about you? Let's say not the, will there be different venues? More, is there more of a concert style arena, let's say, maybe coming up in 2023? Okay, so we're going to keep that on the down low?
Maybe. I don't know. I mean, it's been, so this is why I'm saying maybe, because, you know, things are always talked about.
Right.
But sometimes it doesn't end up happening because, like, but it's talked about. And now, like I'm saying, I'm very, like, right now, I'm like very hungry and I'm in this hustle mode. So I will annoy anyone and I will continue to, you know, just blow up
persevere,
their phones.
Keep,
yes.
Yeah. You know, sometimes persevere. People say, oh, you know, you're being a pest about situations and anything we do in life.
I don't even look at it that way
anymore.
Yeah,
you have to keep pounding that pavement because, you know, out of sight, out of mind if you don't.
Exactly, out of sight, out of mind. But no, there has been some conversations with different people. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see.
Okay.
Fingers crossed.
Good to know. And you know what? If something like that does happen, you're going to be on. It was said here on this podcast.
Yes. So
we'll do it that way. But
we'll
I want to leave
see.
You like this. I what is, in closing, just a few things I wanted to ask you. For right now, like, what is the most comfortable venue for you right now? And you've played it, like you said, not only Chicago, you've played in different areas, arenas, different places. What's one of your favorite moments for Daniela Crocco as the Jersey girl or Daniela Crocco, the vocalist? What was, like, what is that one that sticks out in your mind that says, baby, I got this. I'm good and bad on the dance floor. What made it happen for you? Which was the one?
What gig? Like, what?
Yeah, what was that gig that still comes up to you in the mind? Like, what, you know, when I was playing hockey, I still remember a game. What was that gig for you? You know, it was like, hey, wow.
I don't know.
You know.
I mean, oh my God.
Come on, I didn't stump Daniela Crocco.
I'm trying to think. Like, so just a particular gig.
Who was
where
that one
I'm,
that's still like, wow, they came up to you afterward or they were talking about it weeks later? Like, wow, you know, I really kicked ass on this one.
Trying to pinpoint, like, I, because there are a few.
Well,
there's
yeah,
a few.
You can name a couple of them.
I mean,
what are the ones that, you know, like, you wowed the crowd?
I'm trying to think, like, recently.
You know, I gotta pay, you know, Daniela, I gotta pay for the Zoom, you know.
Oh my God. Oh,
probably.
Let's see. I have my mom here in the background. She keeps looking
hi to
at
Teresa
me. Because I can just, I already sense her trying to, like, remind me of something. Because that's
okay.
What she
it's
likes
okay.
to do.
That's, I'm glad to tell, give
what?
Her a hug for me.
She just rolled her eyes at me.
What's a venue here that you feel comfortable in?
So that's what you were first saying. That
yeah,
I know
was first
I can
saying
answer.
Yeah. What's the venue here? How do you feel like when you're at Arcata on a Sunday?
I'll tell you where I feel the most comfortable. I know it's going to be the best show ever. Every time, Bellagio.
Okay.
There's an energy about Bellagio. I mean, I don't know what it is.
Is it the smaller people quarter? That go there. Is it the smaller quarters and they're right on top of you?
I think it's a combination of everything.
Yeah.
But honestly, I'll say for me, just like different. Okay, so different gigs I've done here where I know I feel comfortable. Doesn't matter if it's by myself with the girls, right. Who's there. I feel at home. Bellagio, and honestly, I'm going to say Taylor Street.
Okay. When Ronnie's having the fest in the summer?
Yeah. I know it's kind of random, but
stage me, again, they're right on top of you.
Well, yeah. And I don't know. Every time I perform at Taylor Street, I always have a good vibe. And now I will say it's not going to be as much the same these next years because so the reason I say this is we have our cousin that has lived on Taylor Street for like ever. Okay. So every time I perform at Taylor Street, my family comes.
Right.
It's just a tradition now. It's just become this thing. And I don't know. It just feels like it's just like it's a moment for me. Like we had our cousin who's no longer alive, but like
yeah,
he grew up on Taylor Street. And like he never got to see me now that I'm singing in it. I just think like how cool would that have been if our cousin Anthony
it would have been a comfort zone.
Perform on his block.
Sure.
Like at Taylor Street.
Sure.
I don't know. And there's always like very nice moments with Taylor Street. Like there was a year that I did it. I sang Nessun Dorma. Here's a moment where I felt very moved. Okay. There was a woman that came up to me and I sang the song and that was how I ended my show. Usually that's always how I ended my show. She came up to me and she was like, I am so moved by this. I was literally just walking past and I had a relative pass away and just hearing you sing this, like I am, like I just moved her and she was just telling me that.
Yeah.
And she cried, like she literally just cried to me. And I'm like, oh my God. It was such a nice, it's
what
a nice
feeling.
Feeling.
Right?
But those are the moments that I'm like, this is why I do what I do and why I love doing it.
It's
so nice. Like another time, like I had another woman stop me randomly in the middle of the street and I was singing Elton John. I'm telling you, like just the most like random moments, but she came to find me just to tell me how I moved her just by singing the song. I don't know.
And you talk about a confidence, like you were saying a couple of minutes ago to me, you were saying, you know, I'm in this mode right now where, you know what, I'm going to go and get it. Those are the moments that keep you going in your mind, you know, that confidence. Well, listen, I'm going to end it like this because I'm not going to take up your whole Friday night, even though it is like 90 below zero.
Right. I've got a lot of things to do.
Yeah, we will.
No. I've got so many parties to attend to tonight.
Well, no, but when we pause this, we'll pause it. I'll talk to her. But I'm just going to say like this to you. I've even heard you sing at the Columbus Day Parade. Of course, like I heard that national anthem for the 16 in Softball Hall of Fame. Young lady, you have surrounded yourself around good people. And yes, I like what you said. When you surround yourself around good people, good things are going to happen. Daniela Crocco, you keep doing what you're doing. You got to promise me a part two. You're going to come back here because
Absolutely. We're
going to do it again. But
you,
young lady, I'm very proud of you. And thank you for coming on here. This was a real invigorating interview for me.
Oh, good. Thank you. I'm glad.
This is great.
Thank you.
All right, everyone. We will get this out to the public so we can see Daniela and where she's going to be performing and here in the upcoming 2023. And maybe she'll let go of her little secret too, but we'll go from there.
I mean, I really do have a big secret. I don't know. There are things that could happen and things I might be here a year from now and it still be the same story. Oh, you know, I'm still singing here and there.
Right.
I don't know.
All right, everyone. Good night, everyone. And Daniela, thank you so much. And keep doing what you're doing.
Thank you.